Hey guys, today we're just going over some little basics that we do to rejuvenate your headlights and upgrade them. The number one thing we like to do to upgrade a halogen housing is we like to change out the bulb. So we prefer to use a high quality LED replacement bulb that has a good operating voltage range so it can work in a variety of vehicles, and we prefer the ribbon style. The reason why we use the ribbon style for heat sinks is it doesn't take up that much space and no moving parts. There are larger versions of heat sinks. You might run into spacing issues. This one you wouldn't really have that, so you could do that. I would stay away from fans as well. You want something that has more than a year warranty on it. Like some have like five, some have up to 10-year warranty, like these ones that we put in. So that is the top thing that we like to do because it's going to give us a nice bright white light. You can see it goes inside the housing and it fits perfectly. And what we do is we make sure that the LEDs are facing side to side. This will use the housing as best as possible and control it as best as possible. These are clockable too. So once it locks in, you can still rotate it to aim it properly. So you can experiment. Put it up and down, even at a diagonal, you'll notice that the beam doesn't work correctly, and it works most correct just like the halogen one when side to side. So if you can look here, they even show you how the light spreads on halogen versus LED. So yes, there are a lot of products out there. You have to find one that works consistently for styles like this. And as you can see, we have a nice crisp white light. And those amber little peanut bulbs look really good in there. Next, you want to restore it. So you can go more aggressive. I've seen tons of videos where people wet sand the plastic quite a bit. But there are products out there from polishing companies like Meguiar's that make compounds specifically for plastic. So you can see here, there's a line that's more predominant on the headlight that I haven't touched. So you see yellowy, hazy. This is basically, I think, where the air is coming up most aggressively. And then salt and everything's hitting it like a sandblaster. And we have, you can even feel it. There's this wear that's happening as the elements are hitting the lens. Here, you can't feel it as much. It's still there, you can see it very faintly. So I've probably polished this about 5 times now with several blue shop towels. You see everything coming off of it. But this is looking pretty good for just buffing it by hand. I prefer to do it by hand because it's just not so aggressive on the plastic. It's a good idea to put a little masking tape, clean the paint, put masking tape so you don't get any of the compound on it. And I just keep polishing it. I don't even, until it clears up. You let it go to a haze. And just keep doing that over and over again, and then clean it and get it ready for your paint protection film. So now that wear line is pretty much non-existent, I feel like pretty much everyone gets to this point pretty good. They will wet sand, whatever, polishing compounds looks great, and then everyone will add clear coat on top of it afterwards. We all know paint can wear over time, so why put clear coat? You're not going to wax your headlights all the time. Use paint protection film, clear stuff. It works great on headlights. It doesn't degrade the performance of the headlight, and it self-heals in UV light. You see here, this is why you want to have a professional do this work. It's sized up and it's worked on, and I think this is just way better to do it this way as opposed to using clear coat.
those ones still last quite a bit.
Alright, the protection film is now on there. These headlights are looking really good. And what I like about doing this is, I think headlights should go back to this. If manufacturers were to design the housing for LED, but use standard bulb styles with LED replacements, I know they'll never do it, but newer headlights now are easily $2,000 if they're full LED. And if an LED were to burn out, what happens is you have to just change the whole thing. If this decides to stop working, I could just change it out to a 194. If this stops working, I change it out to an H11. We can also add in load resistors and change these out to LED as well. And I could do a switchback if I wanted to, because this is a marker light and signal. So we can do cool things within this housing, and this housing isn't super expensive. It's probably like $300 to $400 from Ford. If you go to Depot or Depot, it's probably like a $200 to $300 housing. So it's still relatively inexpensive compared to factory LED to change out. And like, this headlight looks pretty good to me considering it's from 2008. All right, let's remote start it and then check out operation. So it's not gonna be perfect because we still have some wear from the inside of the light. Remember, this is from 2008 and this is the original headlights on the truck, but looks pretty good to me. There you guys have it. That's how to rejuvenate and upgrade your headlights to have a much more long-lasting setup.